I'm going to talk about using Excel files with macros from your Dropbox. If you have many people from different locations that need to access the same file, a Dropbox works really well. But there's a few problems with it. So here I have my Dropbox open and I have search form XLSM. Obviously it's got a macro in it. So let's click on this. And then you can open it. And it brings you to Office Online, which is very handy. When it opens an Office Online, you notice that the file's here, and you can certainly edit it. But I have a macro that runs a search, so I don't have to type in the numbers for different things I'm trying to enter PO numbers for. So this doesn't work for me at all. So let's go back to our original Dropbox. So I'm back in my original Dropbox, and I now want to run it with the macros. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to download it. And you click on the download, and then it puts the form or the downloaded form on the bottom of your window. So I'm going to drag it out to my desktop. So here I have it here on my desktop. So I double click to open it. So now I have my file open with all of the nice feature, which is the first search form. So I can go click on the search form and it pops up my user form one, and I can proceed to enter the PO numbers that I need using the macro that's in there. Now, what I'm going to do when I'm finished with this is I'm going to save it as the next number. So it's search form one, and so I'm going to save it as search form two. So I'll change this to two and save. So now I can go back to my desktop. I can upload the files that I've just created. So here it is. And then it's done. And so then what I would do, so the search form two has the changes that you've made here. So I would delete my search form one. So that's how you work with Excel files with macros from the Dropbox. Please subscribe.